Hi, I'm Stuart from SMB Networks. Welcome to the next job. Let's go and have a look, see what it's all about. Okay, so here we are. We've got this stone gable to cap. It's quite a big run. I haven't measured it yet, but it does look at least 4 meters, I guess, a side. Must be at least 4 meters, maybe more. We'll get a tape measure on that soon and see exactly how big that is. Not the best finish to go to. I'll have to try to get all this off. That's all gonna show up on the lid. And it's gonna be quite awkward to get in that side as well. That's gonna be interesting. So we've got this up and over to cap here. Also at the bottom of this, the builder wants me to do something with that. Try to cover up this, I guess. So I think what I'm gonna probably end up doing on this is cutting a piece of lead the shape of the stone there, fix it in there. I might talk to him to see if I can get some ply or something on that, because obviously these metal straps are not ideal. See what he wants to do about that. So we can certainly cover that up. That's not a problem, make that look nice. So first thing we'll do, I think, is we'll get all these snots all cleaned off this stone. We'll get some measurements to find out sort of like what size panels we're going to do this in. I'm going to weld these because obviously it's all exposed to wind lift, etc. So I'll weld it all together, and we'll do a welted front edge as well, and no doubt probably a welted back edge as well. So we'll get it all cleaned off, start setting out where some welts are going to come, and then we can get some copper fixed into this stone, and get some building paper on there and go from there. Okay, so I guessed this at 4 meters, didn't I? It's actually 3 meters 865, but bizarrely I'm actually closer on this side, which is 3 meters 920 for some reason. You would expect that to be even, but for some reason that one just must oversell a little bit further than the other side. So anyway, we know our sizes now. I've also just marked out where all my welts are gonna go. Just gonna do meter sections. Apart from this top one here, it's gonna still be a meter panel, but it's just gonna be 500 either side to center the welt. I'm just going to give this a 35mm drip. I don't want to come down too low, because we want to see, you know, we don't want to cover up too much of this nice stonework. So we're just going to come down 35mm, which would be about I think it's about 15mm lower than that edge there. Right, so now we've got it all worked out, I'm going to get some building paper on here now and then transfer all my marks, and then we can start looking at getting some copper fixed into place. Okay, so I've got all the building paper in place there now, up and over. I've set out and marked all the welts on the paper, so that's all ready to go. Also, now all the copper is in place now, and that's ready now to take some lead. But I think what I'm going to do first, I think I'm going to concentrate on those two front sections, get them bits done, then we can start working our way up. Okay, so slight change of plan. I decided to leave the bottom sections for the time being. I wanted to concentrate on getting some of the area on first. So I'm already working my way up this first side now. I've got four panels on. It is quite difficult, actually. Surprisingly, how much these weigh. They're only 940 of 800 Co5 centres. But actually trying to get them hooked into the welt and fixing it while it's on the pitch on your own is quite difficult. But I am managing to do it just about. It's a bit of a struggle, but we're getting there. You can see I've got plenty of fixings in there as well to keep each panel in. So we're going to have the copper fixing every panel, and obviously once it's welted together as well and hooked, that's also helping to keep everything from slipping. And when you dress down these two sides, there's no way that these welts can ever lift up. So that's going to be absolutely fine. So we've done as much as we can do on that side at the moment. What we're going to do now is concentrate on coming up this side. meeting to this point here, then we can do the apex. Okay, so I've worked my way up on this side now, right up to this last section to put on. And put a bit of patination oil on that side. So what I'm going to do now is get this apex piece in. I'm going to have to do this slightly differently. I won't be able to hook this side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook this side, set that weld in, roll the lid round, and then it'll sort of like it'll hold as long as I get it round to this point there. Then I can roll it round, lift that weld up, weld them two bits together, and dress it all back down again. Well, that's the plan anyway. So hopefully that's how it's gonna go. Okay, so I've just got this last section going in now. So yeah, so I've just done a hook weld on that one, hook that in, make sure that's fully in, set that weld in there. Rolled the lead round to this point, and that sort of like kept it all in place. Fold it down and just turn up the weld where it meets the next section. Then I just had to dress this 25mm back up. What I'm going to do now is just get a bit of heat on there, heat up that extra 25mm there, fold them, weld them two together, and then just set that down again. Okay, so that's that last section in place now. Welted together. So what I think I'm going to do now is get a bit of patination oil on this side as well, and then I can have a look at doing these two fronts. Okay, so it's now the next day. I was just going to concentrate first off of getting these two front sections done, bottom bits, but I think actually what I'm going to do now is concentrate on getting all of this edge down. That's what I'm going to do for this. I've just got a piece of timber here, 35mm. I'm just going to put that onto the underside. Just dress that lead down, cut out where it meets the weld, dress that to the timber, fold it back on itself, and then just dress it against the side of the stone. So I'm just going to work my way up there now, getting all this edge down. Okay, so that's all that weld turned in now against that timber. Just picked up all the copper when that turns it in. Can dress this against the stone now. Okay, so that's that edge dressed up against the stone now. Just now I've done that, I'm going to concentrate on getting these two bottom sections done. Okay, so that's both those bottom sections in there now. I just cut a piece of lead to the shape of the stone, drilled and fixed that in place, then dressed the other one down over the top of it. So that's both of those done now. So now we've done that. What I need to do now is get this other edge down on the inside of the roof. Okay, so that's that inside edge all dressed down as well now. So all that's left to do now is a few corners to weld. I've got two corners to weld up there. Got another corner to do down there. It's another horrible one to do in there. It's a broken slate there that needs to be changed as well. I have to get on that. And then around the other side here. Another corner to do there, another one there, and there's another broken slate there, and there's another broken slate there. So we've got a few broken slates to change as well. So we're going to get all these corners welded in, and then that'll be just done. Okay, so that's all those corners welded now. I've also put some fixings at the bottom of these end panels as well, just for belt and braces really. To be honest with you, like without it I couldn't lift it up, but I just wanted to be 100% certain that that is never gonna go anywhere. So I've just put a couple of fixings in the bottom there as well. So that's now all oiled as well, that side. Just welded up these gussets as well. Again, just done the same thing there, just put a couple of fixings at the bottom there to prevent any wind lift, and that's oiled up there as well. Now I didn't do the other lead work on this job, but I have just done a little bit of mastic pointing as well that somebody left previously, so I've just done that as well. So that is now job done. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. You can check me out on Instagram at SOBLeadworks. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Hopefully catch you in the next. Cheers.